और श्रीमती एस ज्योतिमणि
जी,
इंटेंशन ऑन स्पिरिट ऑफ द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ चिल्ड्रन फ्रॉम सेक्सुअल ऑफेंसेस अमेंडमेंट बिल 2019. अकॉर्डिंग टू द 2015 एनसीआरपी क्राइम रिपोर्ट, देर आर अराउंड 11,000 cases of rape reported against children in India. In 2016, it's almost around 20,000. It's double. That it is a case of reported cases. There are many cases, like hundreds of thousands of cases might have gone unreported. We all should still hang our heads in shame for collectively failed our children. As Minister rightly said, this August House again collectively gather the strength and the support and the empathy for their children and their future. I appreciate the Minister for bringing this bill. I agree that it's a high time we made more stringent and effective law for the protection of children's sexual offences. I appreciate that the bill increases the minimum punishment from 7 years to 10 years for the offence of penetrative sexual assault. I also welcome the stricter punishment with imprisonment between 20 years to life and a fine if a person commits penetrative sexual assault on a child below the age of 16 years. The bill also adds two more grounds to the definition of aggravated penetrative sexual assault. This includes assault resulting in death of child and assault committed during a natural calamity or in any similar situation of violence. The bill increases the minimum punishment from 10 years to 20 years and the maximum punishment to death penalty. So I would like to convey the Honorable Minister through you, ma'am. When it comes to a juvenile, actually we request you to consider that death, not to give a death penalty to them. Because I'll tell you why. Because the perpetrator is a juvenile. There might be a chance he himself a victim. So I will come to that point, how actually children who are victimized in their young age, assaulted, raped and molested, can become a potential offenders in later part of their life. So considering that, actually I request the Minister through you, ma'am, to send the bill to the standing committee for this reason, actually to have a detailed discussion again to not include the juvenile in the death penalty. This I also appreciate the fact that the bill clearly defines child pornography as any visual depiction of sexually explicit conduct involving a child, including photograph, video and digital or computer generated images. So this is the era of digital era. So any other thing, technology also prone to misuse. So this is the one way, actually we are, technology can be handled by anybody now. We don't have a control. We should not have a control also, though it's misused at times. So where actually we are creating awareness to the children. So one thing which actually I personally feel that one thing this is diluted in the bill is the government has reduced the punishment for the use of children for pornographic purposes, which can be resulted in sexual and aggravated sexual assault. This could have been considered. So when we come to punishment, I also would like to bring into the notice of the August House, we hear many speakers, my colleagues have spoken in before me, the stringent acts actually will not result in a very good way. While the bill proposes several amendments for more stringent punishment, it fails to address the issue of poor conviction rate under the Act. More than 1 lakh cases were registered from 2014 to 2016, according to the National Crime Bureau. However, only 10% trials were implemented and the conviction rate in 2016 was only 30%. Incidentally, law ministers are also here. So the shortage of judges in the judiciary, though the bill proposes a separate court for the trial, and where are we and what is the time limit actually we are going to have the trial and the punishment. So this is the one issue which is related with judiciary which might affect this act. I would also feel one thing with this bill is the bill is mostly focused on actually preventing children once the assault happened. So there is no preventive mechanism for the children in this bill. It's not even addressed. This also addresses only perpetrators, not the victims. So when we are all we are all here to cross that age. So whenever, even I personally believe that only when I was around 25, 26, I'm from a village. I thought only girl children are actually going through sexual harassment. One of my friend's son one day was alone at home when an electrician came to fix some problem. None of us were at home. That guy actually tried to molest that kid. That kid doesn't even know what it is. When we back in the home, actually he was in tears. Then he said, what happened? He said, actually this guy did this, did that to me. But then we are now roughly talking about good touch and bad touch. But I don't think it is enough. Actually, there was a time, actually I remember that in 2004, I think UPA government started discussing about sex education in the school. I attended one of the hearing which was run by now present Honorable Deputy Chairman of Rajya Sabha, where actually a lot of views came in. So now it's since a decade past, we have to rethink those things. See, how many families, how many schools actually listen to our children? I've been listened to girls, especially 14, 15, even 17, when not even sexual assault, somebody actually tried to tease them, or they wanted to say a boy actually coming behind their cycle and all, when they go to home and tell them that actually this has happened, then some of the families say, what's wrong with you? You don't go to school. Take leave for 10 days, 15 days. So that makes victims actually perpetrators. So this cannot be done. So this has to be, minister actually hold, not only, he also hold the woman empowerment portfolio. So one thing actually, whenever we come to the rape, so we generally think actually punishment can reduce the rape. But how this intention of rape, assault or molestation or domestic violence come? See, where it stems from, it's not only physical act, it's basically stems from the mental thought. A woman can be we are telling children how to woman is inferior to men. We are telling children actually how is woman is on a man can ownership of a woman body and soul and life, everything. So these are all the things actually we are ready to teach children directly or indirectly. But we are not ready to teach children actually how to protect themselves, how to understand their body, how to understand the body's reaction, how to stop someone else touching them in the private parts, and have the courage and strength to tell them actually you can't do this to me. So these are all the very important things. Personally, I feel actually from the victim part, the bill has to be taken care of. Even the woman cases. So there is not much more difference from the sexual assault on a woman or rape on a woman or children. It also has a mental feeling, it's not only physical. So this cannot be controlled or reduced or stopped only by making laws stringent. Actually, also we need to address the issue from the beginning, maybe from the school syllabus. Actually, ministry can work with the Human Resource Development Ministry regarding this. It's also sometimes actually somebody you trust, you know, or is part of the family that affects more devastating effect. They sometimes feel that the experience is their fault. It has happened to them. There could be issue with self-esteem and of feeling ashamed of it. They feel bad enough for themselves. They might feel ugly. They might feel themselves as a bad person. Having a safe environment that enables victims to share their experiences can help them to move forward in life. The space has to be accepting, empathic and validating. It's important to process the anger they feel and know that it's not their fault. When it comes to anger, that is how actually we are opposing this death penalty for juvenile, because there might be a potential anger actually went into the child that may reason from not all the child, maybe that may be a main reason for someone, a juvenile, to become a perpetrator. So I request the Honorable Minister to consider this fact, especially the...
இந்த வீடியோ உங்களுக்கு பிடிச்சிருந்தா, please like and share பண்ணுங்க. மறக்காம எங்க சேனல subscribe பண்ணுங்க.